Forever could never be long enough for me. Feel like I've had long enough with you.
All right, we're on, baby.
All right. A lot of you have been asking Kendra and I about our proposal story and just how it all went down, so we thought the easiest way to do that is, you know, sit down, make a little video. Talk about how I asked this girl to marry me.
So he got the whole actual proposal on video because he strapped his GoPro to the front of his truck. So we're gonna talk a little bit about how it went down, and then we are going to just show you the raw footage. Okay, I'll start. Josiah had taken my planner, and he had planned 10 perfect dates. All on consecutive weekends throughout this term. The first date was recreating our actual first date, where it was going to Abaca Falls, then we went to Bend, then to Crater Lake, then to his house, to my house, bike rides, coast trips. Like, these were ideal dates, and he just planned them on his own. He was gonna swoop me away, really romantic.
We talked about it, and like, we knew that I was gonna propose some point during this term, and when I sat down and looked at it, I was like, okay, there's no way I'm gonna be able to pull this off without Kendra knowing coming up to it. Okay.
Because I'm a digger. I like to dig and figure things out.
And I wanted her to be surprised, so I sat her down and I said, look, you know, I'm taking you on a series of dates every weekend this term. It may happen on one of these dates, it may happen in between one of these dates, but, you know, it's probably going to happen at some point this term.
So he's trying to keep me on my toes.
So I'm trying to keep her on her toes, and if I do something unexpected, take her on some beautiful date, it's just part of the normal scheme of things, you know. I told her, like, look, you know, there's gonna be cameras on every one of these dates, so really, camera doesn't mean anything to you, you know, so.
He tried to desensitize me.
Look, just have your nails done, you know, be ready, and let's have some fun this term. So, the second date in, we're going to Smith Rock, so we're driving over there from Corvallis, we're going through Tombstone Pass, and I took a left turn off of the highway.
Because he had a viewpoint to show me. I thought nothing of it because he's pretty spontaneous. So I was like, oh yeah, we're going to do some off-roading, go look at this viewpoint. Thought nothing of it.
So I take her down this like old logging road. You know, we hit the snow. I stop. I put the truck in four-wheel drive. I put the GoPro in. I zip tie it to the hood of the, or to the grill of the truck. And I
knew he put a camera on his truck, but I thought it was just for off-roading footage. Because, you know, like, the man loves his truck.
Yeah, so I just told her, you know, I wanted some off-road footage. and you know.
What you guys are going to see next is the actual footage we got from the GoPro all the way through the proposal and a little bit of celebration afterwards. You don't really want to explain too much until the end, so enjoy the raw footage and we'll see you in a couple minutes. I think that went well.
We can leave it all.
Okay.
Alright, so we're back.
No. They just watched this romantic. Anyway, so there is the footage that Joe captured on his GoPro. So we want to explain a little bit about what happened. We're driving to this viewpoint and there's a giant log, as you guys saw, and we needed to move it out of the road. And so Joe goes to grab a tow strap to move it, and I'm like,
we don't need a tow strap. We work out. Let's just push this off the edge.
Yeah, so you can't really see it in the frame, but off to the left side of the road is just a ravine. It's just 30
giant
feet
cliff.
Straight down.
Here I am, just casually rolling my proposal off the edge. No, but as you guys saw, Joe like swooped in. He stopped me and he's like, babe, come look. And you guys saw, once I saw the log, obviously something hit. And what he had done is, I'll insert a picture, but what he had done was engraved in that log, will you marry me? And then by the time I turned around, he was getting down on one knee. Yeah.
Don't go. I had the ring in my boot the whole day.
His church boot. He's wearing his nice church boots and he had it just tucked away. So we knew for sure we wanted to get married in San Francisco, I would say. That's when I knew that.
Zazie's, yeah. Specifically.
We were at a brunch.
Yeah. Yeah. Last summer.
Yeah, last summer.
Started putting the plan together in late November, early December. Kind of figured it out a bit. I went up there 2 weeks before I proposed, and then also a week before I proposed to that same spot, and that's where I found the tree fallen in a storm.
Yeah. And now we're turning it into a bench, which we'll keep in our home. So we've known we wanted to get married for a while. We just like truly believe it's God's will, and that you and I, that's what we were both created to do, like with each other, was to build that covenant together. And oh my gosh, the story goes on.
The proposal happened. Obviously, there's no cell service. So we're driving back down the mountain. Kendra's checking her phone for like as soon as she gets cell service.
I have to call my mom, I have to call my friends.
She's got a laundry list of people to call. So we get to cell service, you know, she calls her mom and then she starts calling her friends. And
all my closest friends denied me. They're like, oh, I'm in a fraternity meeting. Oh, I'm at a shoe. I'm, you know, like with my husband, whatever. And I was like, well, shoot, none of my friends are gonna hear the news. Until we get to our destination and we met our friends that we were expecting to meet, and we walk in to what I thought was their house, but it was a giant Airbnb that Josiah had rented. And all the friends I had called, my friends from growing up, like my soul core friends, were there. You're just smiling. Were there to surprise me with champagne and balloons and music and just love and support. And
this man, my fiancé,
planned it all.
Yeah, and then we woke up the next day, did our Smith Rock hike that I promised her, and then, you know, made the long trek back home to Corvallis. I had one more surprise in store. I take the exit, go to my parents' house.
We walk into his parents, you know, say hey, we're excited, and out pops my entire family, his entire family. More surprises and just, but surprises filled with just people who love us and support us. Joe planned it all and it was honestly beautiful. And even though we had those little surprises, like just the fact that we get to spend the rest of our lives together, you get to be my husband.
Yeah.
That was just,
yeah.
It was beautiful. A testament of God's love and God's goodness,
provision,
honestly.
Really?
Yeah.
Yeah.
So that's our story. Hashtag bring it on is our wedding hashtag. We hope to share the love.